Last week, I went on a trip to Germany to visit my friend there, which was an amazing trip. But there's one thing I realized there. As I was going on this trip, I realized that I was trying to stay productive all the time. And since I make videos about productivity, I read books about productivity, I preach productivity, I live productivity, I thought to myself, how come that I can't fit everything in? I'm trying to journal, I'm trying to meditate, I'm trying to stretch, I'm trying to work out, I'm trying to improve myself by reading, I'm trying to learn new things, be a better person, and all these self-help things you might want to do. And I thought to myself, why can't I, for some reason, balance these things out? I should be able to do it. I mean, I try to teach other people how to do it, then I should obviously be able to do it. But I came to realize one critical thing, which is that you can't balance them all out. And that's the number one problem with self-help life, self-help world, if you will. So my name is Sander, and today I'll be talking a little bit about this, and hopefully I'll be giving you some tips to go about this problem, because this is quite the problem, right? So on the one side, we have you're wanting to improve yourself, you want to get better, you want to learn more, you want to learn faster, you want to get better, you want to be stronger, you want to be healthier, you want to be more productive. And on the other side, you have your actual real self, if you will, where you have friends who want to hang out with you, you have expectations versus reality, if you will, right? You have getting sick, you have all the other things that might ruin your productivity streaks, right? For example, if you go out at night drinking and you get back at 5 in the morning, the chances of you actually going to meditate are rather small, right? So to balance that out, you need to have some sort of mindset switch where you understand that you can't have everything, right? And when I say you can't have everything, I don't mean that you can't make a million, you can't have a jet. I just mean that when it comes to productivity, it's very easy to sometimes think of, I have to do this and that, and if I don't, then it's all a waste, which is a trap I fall into myself a lot of times, because sometimes I can't do something 100%, right? I read 6 out of 7 days in the week, and I'm thinking to myself, I set the goal of reading every day, so now I failed, so I might as well do nothing next week because I achieved literally zero, even though 6 out of 7 days during the last week, I had actually read a book. So to counter that feeling, you need something specific. And that specific thing is what I want to talk to you about, because that thing is a mindset. You need a mindset to help you out here. A mindset which helps you to stop overanalyzing, stop overcriticizing yourself, and helps you to stay focused, have that tunnel vision on a goal, but also allow yourself to blossom out into different types, right? Because sometimes when I'm meditating, reading, stretching, working out, going to bed early, waking up early, not drinking alcohol, not doing drugs, not doing this, not doing that, sometimes it's literally like a full-time job at some point, right? Because if you have to have a morning routine for 1 hour, then you have a night routine of 1 hour, then you have a midday meditation and for like 30 minutes, then you have a 2-hour workout, then you also need to do cardio at night, then you need to study, you need to be productive, you need to do the Pomodoro technique. Like, when are you gonna fit all these things in? Well, the number one thing I'd say you have to try is stop relying so heavily on these routines. Like, you need to rely on them in times of stress, in times of need, but you need to prioritize. And this is something that is very hard, but this is the way I like to do it. I like to think, if today would be my last day, if it were to be my last day, right? What would I do and what wouldn't I have to do per se, right? For example, if I had my last day today, I personally would meditate and read and maybe stretch, or do a workout. I wouldn't try to go for some cardio. I wouldn't try and go for a early wake up or a long night. And I don't mean a YOLO type of, I just had my last day. I don't mean, oh, if it's my last day, I'm snorting cocaine. Obviously, I don't mean that. I don't indulge in any form of drugs, nor do I recommend it, right? So obviously, that's not what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to say that which ones are the most important, then make a routine surrounding that, and then stick to that routine regardless of circumstances. But make it so that when your routine is impossible to stick to, for example, when I went on my trip to Germany, then you need some sort of halfway routine, some place where you can meet in the middle with your feelings of, right, I'm gonna be able to do this, and I'm gonna meet halfway in the middle because that's where I'm okay with sacrificing some of the things. For example, when I went to my friend in Germany, I did journal every day, I meditated every day, but I didn't work out on my usual schedule. I did try to stay active, I did go for walks. I had to compromise though, and at some point in life you need to compromise on these things. So obviously it's great going to classes every single day on the perfect streak and telling yourself, oh, I'm such a good student. But realistically, like looking at it, sometimes in life there's more important things, right? Sometimes there's a birthday coming up from a really important person. Sometimes there is something else really important around you that needs to happen. For example, going to install a new cabinet in the kitchen, which is gonna help you further down the road. And obviously, yeah, you're a great student, good for you, like not skipping any classes. But what you're really doing is having a tunnel vision and not understanding the bigger picture here. And the bigger picture sometimes is to let things go, which might seem counterproductive, but at the end of the day, you'll be more productive because you will be more recharged. You'll have a stressless feeling, if you will. You'll feel nice and relaxed because you're ready to go and you've taken care of the things that you really needed to take care of. And it's really nice knowing that you're not psychotic about the fact that you have to do specific rigid routines every single night, otherwise you won't be able to fall asleep. Obviously I need my meditation or my journaling, right? But it's not like if I miss one single day I'm gonna go full on panic mode to try and fall asleep, because that's still not gonna work. You need to find a routine, and that's with school, that's with working out, that's with food. You need a healthy rigid routine, but you also need a good one to fall back upon in times where it's not possible to do everything. You can't go on a backpacking trip and expect to have a perfectly split workout routine, 6 days a week, doing cardio every morning, doing a workout every night. You won't be getting it, right? So you have to have this compromise routine. And that's where I advise you to look at your routine, look at your rules, look at your standards, and think, what would be half of this? Where would I be okay with still going? Am I not a little bit too over the top with this? And if you are, and that's what you're about, and it works for you, then be my guest. But personally, I've realized that sometimes when it really is too hard, you need to be able to let go. Because if you're not really let go, like able to let go, your routine is actually what's keeping you stuck in place. And self-help at that point becomes toxic. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you did enjoy this video, then make sure to subscribe for next week's video, Monday, 7 p.m. GMT plus one. And I'll catch you guys there. If you're interested in learning more about me or about any self-help related topics, then make sure to check out the podcast, The Productivity Corner, on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or any other podcasting platform, or just over here on YouTube. Then make sure to subscribe to the channel every Thursday, 7 p.m. GMT plus one across all platforms. And I'll catch you guys there. Peace.